G'day everyone, it's Alistair from Mango's Mapping with you once again. Today, we're going to be talking about Emlid's Flow survey app and the inverse and traverse functions that are available within the paid version of the app. We're here on a farm in far north Queensland, and we're going to pretend to establish the alignment of a fence line alongside this farmer's driveway. To do that, we're first going to pick up a point for the corner post, and then we're going to pick up another point along the alignment of the fence. Using those two, we've then got the angle that we need to be able to traverse along the fence line and establish the marks for each of the fence posts that need to be laid every 4 meters along the alignment of this fence. Let's get started. So I'm using an Emlid RS3 today, and we just need to initialize the IMU. There we go. I'm averaging each position for just 5 seconds, and so we've nearly collected our corner post. Now the next thing I'll do is head down along the alignment of the fence and pick up another point. Okay, so we've now picked up the corner post and we've picked up the gate post further along the fence alignment. And we can now go into the tools menu on the lower left-hand corner of the screen and select the inverse function. Using the inverse function, we can now select points either from the map or from the list. So I'm selecting my corner post and then I'm selecting my gate post, and I can review the relationship between those two points. And one of the things that you can see in there is the angle of the direction, the azimuth. So I'm just going to long tap on that and copy that into the memory of my phone. And now I can cancel out of the inverse function, go back into the traverse function. I can now select a point of origin, the corner post, and in 2D distances, I want to place a point every 4 meters, and then I can place in a direction. And I'm just going to paste in the angle, the azimuth between these two points. I'm going to click done, and I'm going to save new point. So you can see that Emlid Flow has retained the previous post ID. If I'd like to replace that, I can just type straight over the top of that, and then I can save that point. So we're just going to call it post. Okay, now we can see that post point on the screen, and we can see that it's 4 meters from the corner post. So I can now close out of the traverse dialog, close out of my tools menu, select that new post, and we can stake out to it. And I'm not at the corner post at the moment, and you can see that it's nudging me to move up about 6.5 meters to the location of the first post along that fence line. Let's go stake it out. All right, so we have now reached the point at which the next post will be located, and we're just going to measure that as a staked point for our stake report later on and pop a mark on the ground. Having captured that point, I'm going to close out of the stakeout dialog, go back into my traverse menu, and I'm going to rinse and repeat. Except this time, I'm going to use the point that I've just collected, and I'm going to insert the same 4 meter distance once again, and I've still got the azimuth sitting in the memory of my phone. So I can paste that in into the interface. And now we can save that, and we'll just give that post another name and hit save and close out of the traverse menu. And now we can go into our list of points and we can stake that point out. And quite predictably, we can see that that point, if I move back onto the original point, is approximately 4 meters away. Because I've been fairly stationary, I just need to get the IMU working again, and that'll bring it back into that 4 meters. There we go. Yep, 4 meters and 2 millimeters, 1 millimeter, 3 millimeters. Okay, so now we're in a position to go and stake that point out. Don't have to take too many steps when you're 6'8" to get 4 meters. And there we are. We've reached that point again. I'm just going to measure the staked point once again for my stakeout report and make a mark on the ground for this post two. So you can see the process that we've been following here, and iteratively using the most recent point to then stake out another 4 meters along that same alignment. And if we continue that methodology, we should eventually catch back up to the gatepost and be on the same alignment as the gatepost, because we've been using that azimuth, that angle if you like, from north, all the way from the corner post as we shoot along the side of this paddock. I hope you found this video helpful. Please feel free to like the channel, follow us on YouTube, and leave a comment below. Thanks very much for watching. See you next time.